Alleluia, Christ has risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ has risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ has risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let's confess our sins to God, our Maker and our Rescue.
I have lived as if you do not matter, God. I have lived as if I matter most. I have not honored your name as I should. My worship and prayers have faltered. I have not let your love have its way with me. And so my love for others has failed. There are those whom I have hurt and those whom I have failed to help. My thoughts and desires have been filled with sin. Hear my heart cry out for your Lord, as this most troubles me.
Friends, upon this your confession, I as God's servant, your pastor, I give to you the gift of Jesus himself. I forgive you all your sin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's sing our praise.
Which you have heard me speak about. From John's baptism of water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Then they gathered around him and asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know this the time or day the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. After he said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and the cloud hid him from their sight. Men were looking intensely up into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside him. Men of Galilee, they said, why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. Then the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the hill called the Mount of Olives, a Sabbath day's walk from the city. When they arrived, they went upstairs to the room where they had stayed. Those present were Peter, John, James, Andrew, Philip, Thomas, Bartholomew, and Matthew, James, son of Zebedee, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. They all joined together constantly in prayer, along with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brother. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks, Bonnie. And Greg reads to us from Peter's letter. Peter has now come towards the end of his life and is still rejoicing in the good news of Easter.
Dear friends, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that has come on you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you, but rejoice inasmuch as you participate in the sufferings of Christ, so that you may be overjoyed when his glory is revealed. If you are insulted because of the name of Christ, you are blessed, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests on you. If you suffer, it should not be as a murderer or thief or any other kind of criminal, or even as a meddler. However, if you suffer as a Christian, do not be ashamed, but praise God that you bear that name, for it is time for judgment to begin with God's household. And if it begins with us, what will the outcome be for those who do not obey the gospel of God? Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Be alert and of sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of sufferings. And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Greg. Let's stand as we rejoice their good news from our Lord Jesus. Jesus has been speaking with his friends in the upper room, and now he's going out to the Garden of Gethsemane to be arrested and to finish our rescue. And as he goes, he begins praying this beautiful prayer. John 17. After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to all those whom you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have brought glory on earth by finishing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May be seated, friends. So this prayer is so filled with intimacy as the Father and is hearing the Son pour out his heart just before he goes to the cross, and it's so poetic, these words that are repeating like glory, with more and more meaning coming on him as you go around. Sometimes my head almost spins when I hear these words. It's kind of like you're walking in on a couple that's been married for a long time. They've got this shorthand way of speaking to one another. It's kind of hard to understand exactly what they're saying if you don't know all the background. But the words themselves are so simple. This is kind of how the text hits me. Are there any words that especially are helpful to you, or any words that maybe are threatening and show you your sin and your need for? I'm just eager to hear other people talk. I've been alone too long. Anybody have any comments on the words? Let's pick up that glorify that comes again. When Jesus says, glorify your Son, Father, the Son will glorify you. What does that mean, glorify? What does that mean to you? Please, Craig.
Hold in high esteem?
Yeah, kind of lift up, hold in high esteem, right? So when I hear that, it seems at first a little bit strange to me. Why does Jesus say, you know, give glory, you know, lift up your Son? Hasn't the Father always esteemed the Son? What exactly is he praying for there? That your Son may glorify you. I'm asking deliberately to push on it, like what is he really saying there? Give glory, glorify your Son, Father. So they are one. There's only one God. So we're hearing the conversation within the Trinity here, which is just so awesome and so mysterious. So there's a real unity and a glory shared there. But something has changed about Jesus. He has become one of us. So The Father and the Son always shared this glory from eternity, even before the world was created. But now, as Jesus has come to our rescue, even in his humanity, his glory is, well, give glory to me as God and as man is part of what he's praying here, I think. Please, Jim. So yeah, so the peace that's shared there and all that stuff too, yeah. Yeah, that glorify just ties in with all these other big words then too, doesn't it? It's kind of the sum of them. So yeah, he's saying in that last sentence on this page that God always had glorified him. Even before the world began. But now, as God and as man, in your presence. I think the other thing that's going on in this text too, let me show you the, well, I guess it's on this page too. Okay, so the on earth part is part of the thing you're going on too, I think. The Father and the Son share this love, this glory from eternity. But now, what Jesus, the reason he has come, is to bring us into that relationship. So right in the middle there, those are tremendously comforting words to me. You have granted him, the Son, Jesus speaking about himself, authority over all people that he might give eternal life. There's all this gift language there. They don't earn it, it's just given to them. That he might give eternal life to all those whom you have given to him. Just before he's going to the cross, Jesus is praying, Father, I recognize that you have given me these people as a gift for me. And I am going to give them eternal life. This is eternal life. That we actually get to know God, us broken people, because our brother is shining with God's glory. He is God, and he's giving us the gift of God, and he's receiving us as God's gift. Yeah. Yeah, so with that text we saw a couple of weeks ago, you know, we don't even know where you're going. How do we get to the Father? And here Jesus is praying all that stuff, isn't he? It's a gift. They're going to see me, and in seeing me, they're going to know you, the true God. Because you're the one who sent me. And then this all ties in, too, with... So Thursday, tomorrow, for us sitting here, for those watching the video on the weekend, the Thursday before, Thursday is 40 days after Easter. It's the day when Jesus ascends into heaven. And then 10 days after that, or next Sunday, is Pentecost, our red celebration, when Jesus ascends into heaven and takes the right hand of the throne to pour out the gift of the Spirit for all of his people. That we may have that faith birthed into us and know God and receive that eternal life. These words are like a pool. You just dive in, and it looks like there's not much there, but you just dive in, and the deeper you go, it's like it just gets to be like bottomless. There's like so much in these words when you start playing with them. I just encourage you to continue to do that. However, for the sake of brevity, is it okay if we move along now? I put my phone in my pocket because I had a whole bunch of prayer requests that I want to share with you. And I want to give you an opportunity to lift up prayers on your heart too. This weekend, this Monday, is Memorial Day, so we want to give God thanks for those who laid down their lives for our nation, for our freedoms, for good in the world. And a number of prayers here. I'm just going to use first names because this is recorded. But Greg, one of our homebound friends over here at Sarasota Point, is nearly fully recovered from his COVID experience. As far as I know, he's the only person in our whole congregational family that's directly had this dread disease. But Greg is doing well, and thanks Concordia for prayers. Myers is Alice's husband. Myers is home from the hospital a second time after an infection. Marilyn, Ron's wife, was hospitalized and has been at Heartland for almost a week now, completing some rehab. Braden is a friend of Sheila up in Connecticut, who had a dirt bike accident, a young man, and Sheila wanted us to pray for him. Shirley, one of our Saturday night worshipers, had an aneurysm surgery on the 15th and is now home and recuperating well and very thankful that surgery went well. Jenny, another of our homebound nursing care friends. Jenny is in dialysis three times a week, and on top of that, poor Jenny had a fall and fractured her pelvis. They were able to repair it at Doctor's Hospital, and she should be getting out of there today, if not already. Carl and Edna usually worship on Saturday night. Carl has been at Consulate Healthcare for a while now, in Consulate. He is now, as of a couple of days ago, in hospice care. Carl is not doing well. Right across the street, we have a friend who's worshiped with us a few times named Kimberly, who is extending care to her ex-sister-in-law, who is in hospice care, and her sister-in-law did pass away a couple of days ago now. So praying for Kimberly and those grieving for Brenda. Another prayer here is, we know Alice and Denny. Alice, our lead elder. Okay, it's a little hard to follow. Alice's son, Stephen. Stephen's wife, the wife's mother, was engaged to be married. And as Stephen was talking to his future stepfather-in-law, the fellow had a massive heart attack and then passed away. So care and comfort for that family and their sudden grief. Judy Mattis today is having a knee surgery over at Doctor's Hospital. And Marilyn, another of our Saturday night worshipers, Marilyn is Kathy's mom. Was supposed to have a hip surgery today at doctor's, but they have to delay that for a couple of days. So those are some of the many prayers of which I am aware. Are there prayers that you wanted to add this morning? Sandy?
Charles Carroll.
Charles?
For surgery on his leg.
He was hit by a car downtown Brandon a couple years ago.
Okay.
And they tried to set the bone and the infection has set in. And they thought they might have to take the leg off.
Oh boy, okay. So Charles with a leg surgery and possible amputation. Any other prayers, Ellen?
There's a massive storm about to hit Bangladesh and India. Certainly, there will be a great loss of life there. So,
the typhoon that's heading to Southeast Asia there, Bangladesh, India. Please, Mary.
Police department, they lost two officers within the last 2 weeks related to their jobs.
Wow, okay. got family out there that have lost the couple of officers in the police department, job related. Please. The name is Highland, Michigan. The dam break, danger of flooding people in the.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Great risk.
Yeah, big evacuation.
9 feet of water coming.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy with all the troubles in the world, all the other personal problems and world problems, and the wars just continue to rage on, Tim. We need a Heavenly Father to show us Jesus' glory. Carry us through. Let's stand. We're going to speak our faith and then speak our prayers and receive the Lord's gift. We speak our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We pray. The Lord Jesus, lifted on high in glory, you who came to take our sin upon yourself on the cross, having lived with perfect love, having taken our flesh upon yourself and become the perfect sacrifice. Lord Jesus, you rose again with great glory, the promise of the glory that we shall have in our resurrection. Even now, pour out on us that gift of new life given in our baptism. Remind us and strengthen us in that life by the gift of your Spirit, by the power of your word and your work in our life. Receive us, Lord Jesus, as we come to you. And for those of us here able to receive you in your body and blood in the sacramental bread and wine, Lord, we praise you for your forgiveness given time and again, and ask that you would bless us with this food of your presence, that we would be your presence in your world this day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
You heard our prayers for those who are sick, for those who are grieving and struggling, for our friends, for police, for those who are facing typhoon in this world and flood in this nation, and all the other catastrophes that continue to come, Lord. We have no sure place to stand except on you. Enable us, Lord, to rejoice in that faith that you have given to us, that recognizing that we too will be swept away from this land, that we keep our eyes focused on the land that you have won for us, that we may make every difference in this day. For there's so much that we cannot do, Lord, we trust in your care, and we pray that your glory would show, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
These and all the prayers in our hearts we lift to the throne where you have ascended, praying what you have taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
Lord Jesus Christ that very night when he was betrayed, took bread, and my blood shed for you, the forgiveness of your sins. Do this as often as you drink it, remembering me. This peace from Jesus be with you of all of us. Let's together speak the Lamb of God. O Christ, the Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Christ, the gentle Lamb of God, said, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Christ, the sacrifice Lamb, who is God,
you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. You may be seated, friends. I'm going to invite Jim and Bonnie to come forward first to receive our Lord's gift. Give God thanks. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace, as your word promised. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you, be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with good favor and give to you peace. Amen. With this song, we give God thanks for our veterans.